Hi, welcome to an Arduino step-by-step course by Robojax. If you found this tutorial helpful, please thumb up and also click on the subscribe on the right side in the lower corner. I really appreciate it. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use the 7-segment display with Arduino. Hi, welcome to a video tutorial from Robojax. 7-segment display is used in many ways as a counter, for clock, for different purposes, but because it is called 7-segment displays, it has 7 segments, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. There is also a decimal point in case if you want to use it for numbers with decimals, so you can put multiple of these and turn on the decimal point. And the code that I've written and explained here will make it very easy, and you can use it either for common cathode or common anode. I have another video explaining this. I will provide you the code. I will not go through that because it will be just waste of time. Just watch that video, the link will be provided. I will just go directly here with Arduino on how to use this. The 7-segment display that I've used is 5611BH, and this is the common anode. Common anode means anode is all 7 segments of this is all connected to the positive. So anode will be connected to positive, common anode, all of the anodes are connected, and we need to just connect the cathode to the negative so they will be turned on. And Arduino is sending through this wire just 0. When we send 0, this will be turned on. The code that I provide will work with both common anode and common cathode, so you don't have to worry. You just select the type by selecting the type 1 or 0, which will reflect common anode or common cathode. The only thing that you have to do is proper wiring. Common anode will be like this. All the anodes will be together connected to positive because all of them are connected. And the cathode, we have resistor that it goes through this to Arduino. These resistors are limiting the current. Or you can have the resistors instead of in the cathode, you can have it on the anode, and all the anodes are connected still, the same common configuration, and this pin will go to the Arduino, and these resistors do the same job if they are here or there. Or we will have this configuration, that this is common cathode, all the cathodes are connected to the ground, and anodes have a resistor, and these pins goes to Arduino or another source that sends high signal to turn this on. And these resistors, the same way as before, can be on this side. Does not matter as long as the current passes through it, like this. So the resistors are here. They do exactly the same job. And if I put it on this side, and this is decimal point, that is C, D, and E. The middle pin here and the middle pin in here, this is a common. This will go to the positive. Let's start putting the resistors. These are 1 kilo ohm that I'm using. You can use anything between 560 to 1 kilo ohm. For the 5 volts of Arduino, it will be fine. So the first resistor have been inserted here. The rest is empty. The second resistor have been here, connected to the next line, and the rest is empty. Meaning this line is all connected, so one wire is here. And this one also, we have one resistor, and it continues on this side. So this resistor is ended here, the second one row next to it, and then the next row, and then the next row. And the same way, we have started here, one resistor, one, 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 so 4 more resistors here, and they've been connected this way. Now I'm going to connect this to pin 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 6, 7, 8, and 9. And here, now the wires have been connected from this side. One, as you can see, they have been connected in order here. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4. And then here we have 5, 6, 7, 8. And I'm connecting all of this in order from pin 2 to 9. And here now I have connected it. Just pay attention to this diagram. This is, as you can see here, this is B, A. So we have A is the second line. Now this has been, the first one is connected to the A, the second line here. And then this is connected to B. And then the third one is connected via this red wire to C. And this is connected to D, the last second in here. And this has been connected to E, which is the last one, if you see here. And then this has been connected to F, as you can see, the last second. And this has been connected to G. And then the last one, the decimal point, have been connected to H. Here. And we have resistor for each of this LED. Now the code is here. I just need to connect the positive, the common anode in here. And as you can see, it's running with the even brightness, because we have individual LED, and if the number of segments increase or decrease, the density of light will not change. We have consistent light for all of those. Sometimes people just put one resistor for all of these. This is not a good practice, because the amount of light or intensity will be different. For example, if you turn this as one, these two segments will be turned on and there will be a lot of current for that two. But if you put eight, all of these will be on and there will be a lot of voltage drop and the LEDs will be dimmer. So this is not a good practice, but it works. I've connected a bunch of wires here to the LED display directly, and on this side I've connected, they're all in order. This is connected from pin 2 to pin 9. And then there is one extra wire that is connected to 1 kilo ohm. It is connected here to 1 kilo ohm, and it's coming to 5 volts in Arduino at this pin. But these pins are in order. This is for A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. H is a decimal point, so this is in this order, as you see here. And from this side, this is connected to pin A. And here, that's the second one. And then this is connected to pin B. And here, the third one have been connected to pin C. C is this middle one. C, and then the next one, D, and so forth. All of this have been connected in here. As you can see. Here we have connected only one resistor to this 7-segment display. For that reason, the intensity of light when displaying different digits will be different. So it's not advised, but it works. Let me now explain the code. You don't need any library. I've written this code from scratch. So the first thing that you define is the type, either common cathode or common anode. In my case, it's common cathode. I put one here. And if your display is common anode, just change this to zero. And after that, we will define the pins. The pins that I've used is from pin 2 to 8. Just they are in order. If you wish or if you need it, you can change it. But I would not suggest doing that. And then pin 9 is for decimal point. They have been defined as constant, so below this line you don't need to change anything. And this is the display LED's status. We have 7 segments. For 0, everything should be 0 0 0, and then just one point, that's the middle line, should be off. 0, as you can see here, when it comes, only this one is off. The rest is on. That is one would be just off. So in this case, in my case, but you don't have to worry about it. And the same way for one, as you can see, these two will be on, and because this is common cathode, right now these two will be on, so this will be written as one, and so forth. As I said, I have another video explaining that, and also it prints it here. So the array is defined, and then I have a function here. This is called write digit, which is sort from here to here. The job of this one is that when you pass a variable, an integer, like say 5, 6 or whatever, it just prints that number on this. So this will receive a number when you call it, and this prints the digit here, the number that you pass. It prints it as a number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's the number, and then we print a space. So this is the space. After that, we write a for loop. The for loop goes to print every pieces for each LED on this display. So there's each of those for the depending on the type. We have to set those value and send it through the output so that particular LEDs will be turned on. And it goes from 0 to 6 in 7 elements, all of those. And then digital write, it gets the digital display. When you pass this, when I is 0, this goes to digital pin and take that pin from this array. This is 0, this is 1, 2, 3 in terms of position. And the values are 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. But in terms of position, this is V0 and this is 6. So there we type the pen, and then from here we say convert high low. I've written a function to convert it for high or low depending on the common cathode and common anode, and this will take the value. This is the actual value for the screen. It says display LED digit. When you bring that digit, if this is 2, for example, it comes here 0, 1, 2. It gets all these values. But if I is 0, for example, for this one, if I is 0, this value will be picked up. If I is 1, this will be picked up. I is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we will pick them up and we send it to this function, which I'm going to explain next, which will be either high or low. The result of this is high or low. This is as if I type here high, like this. So this will be high and this will be number of pin, because digital write high pin and then high or low, and then this displays each value here. And I did not put LN here. LN mean new line, it will go to the next line, so I did not put it. So they put them the way they are. For example, if you look here for 1, we have only 2 zeros here. You see these 2 zeros, so this value have been printed here to print 1 for us. And this ends. Now, high and low convert. The job of high and low is to get that value that you pass, either 0 or 1. We call it V value. And the job of this one is to convert it. How it converts it, we define a new variable converted value. We check the type. If the type is 0, if it's common anode, what it does is it gets subtracts V from 1. 1 minus, if this is 1 minus 0 is 0, so the value will be 0. If this is 1, 1 minus 1, it will be 0. So it's simple arithmetic. It just changes 1 to 0, 0 to 1, and 0 means low, 1 means high. If it's not, if it's common cathode, the same value will be placed in this variable. It will be stored in here, where we say return converted value. Because the type is integer, this must be integer, it returns it, and this will be the value for us. After this line, we have setup, and the setup is the one that defines all the pins. D from 0 to 8, 0 to 7, and 8 time for all 8 pins, all those pins as output, because we don't want to put this 7 times for all the pins or 8 times for all pins. So we just use the loop, and also we set the decimal point output, and also we set the decimal point high to make it off initially, and then this will be right now, as you can see, this is on, and then we put the serial monitor that is needed to display this text for us, and that number 9600 baud must match this value that is here, otherwise you will not be able to see the text. And this is the main loop that runs continuously printing this for us. And it goes from 0 to 9, equal 9, smaller than equal 9, so it prints 8, 9, and after that it prints this line and waits for 1 second between each digit. And then after that we set the decimal point to be turned on, and then go with this one here. Because decimal point I have not taken care of it, so you have to change it accordingly for your type, common cathode or common anode. Just change this to high and low, because I did not consider that important, because this is just single digit, and the loop continues like that. So if you want to use it for your application and you want to print some value, so you just use this. When you write digit 4, just say write digit and then 4 and wait for 3 seconds. Once all these numbers finished, you will see after 9 it waits for 3 seconds, and then it prints 4 and wait for 3 seconds, and it goes back to the loop. Thank you for watching. This was how to use the 7-segment display with Arduino. Please make sure to subscribe by clicking at the subscribe button in here. Thank you. Thank you for watching the tutorial from Robojax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And don't forget to subscribe so you get updates on my upcoming videos.